Okay, good morning. Today's topic is control flows construct in Julia. Here, what are the control flows here? Here, one is a compound expression. Here, another one here, a compound expression. Here, if you, the compound expression, how can you write here the multiple statements? Instead of writing the multiple statement, you will write a single line statement, different statements in a single line statement. That's called here compound statement. Here, the second one here is a conditional evaluation. The if statement, if else statement, if and statement, and then ternary statement. These two different statements are called as a conditional statements. And then other one is a shortcut evaluation and are, that means chain comparisons. Here, these are all called as a shortcut statement. Another one here is a repeated evaluation. The repeated loop, while loop, and then for loop. These are all called as a repeated evaluation, and then exception handling. Here try catch, and then these are all different control flow constructs here. Here comes to the first one, here is a compound expression. Here, what is a compound expression here? How can you evaluate the compound expression? Here the compound expression, here ordinary statement here, a simple statement here. For example, you will write a simple statement like this, begin, end. For example, begin here, and then you will write some information. For example, here, take information, any information here, x equal to 1, y equal to 1, x plus y. For example, x equal to 1, and then y equal to, for example, 62. And then z equal to, for example, not a z here, take this one here, no problem, x plus y, and then you are writing end here. Here, this is called here, compound statement here. This is a simple, that means you will write a information in a multiple statement. Here, what is the expression result here? If you execute this one here, it produces a result x plus 1. Yeah. It is taking some time. Yeah, the, it will produce a result x plus y. It takes a, that means sometimes here, it's a repeated statement. Here, the statement consists of number of expression. Here, this, if you want to write this statement in a single line, you will use semicolons. Here, that means I am going to writing the same statement by using single line here. For example, x equal to 1, y equal to 2, and then y equal to, not to, okay, 62, and then x plus y. Here, if you execute this one here, it means that is called here compound expression. Here, within a single line, you will write a same statement in a compound expression. By using begin and end also, you will write the compound expression in this way. Here, the begin, end, the x equal to 1, y equal to 2, this particular compound expression here. Here, this particular compound expression, you will write by using semicolon. Here, that is a simple information about the compound expression. Next one here is a conditional evaluation. Here, what is exactly conditional evaluation? Here, how can you do the conditional evaluation? Here, the conditional evaluation here is a if statement, if else statement, and then these are all called as a conditional evaluation. Here, the conditional evaluation represented if, else, if. Here, if, else, if, else. Here, if, else, if statement, you call it as a conditional evaluation. Let us take a simple example here. For example, A is less than B. Here, if you take the A greater than B. Here, let us take simple example for evaluating the conditional expression. If A is less than B. If condition true, then what is the condition here? A is less than or equal. That means you have to print the value A is less than B. If A is greater than B, here you have to print the values here A is greater than B. Here, that means you then in this way, if statement, if else statement, here if else statement, you will write a if else, and then A is equal to B, another condition. That means you are using the three different conditions. A is greater than B, A is less than B, A equal to B. Then you have to do certain operations here. Here that is done by using a simple function. That means I'm going to apply for this one. I'm going to apply a simple function here. Let us take a simple function, evaluation function. Function here, the function name, you may take any function name here. Here the function name here is a condition. Condition of a comma b. Let us take a simple function. The condition here, I am using the simple condition here. Condition of a comma b. Here, that means you choose the function here, you will take the end value. Here condition. If you execute this one here, function condition a comma condition. I am taking the condition. Yeah, the user defined function created this one. Here, if you execute this one, here you call the function. Here, how can you call the function here? For example, 5, 4. 5, 4 in the sense 5 greater than 4. That's why it comes to the second condition. Here, then it will print the value. Here is a 5 is greater than 4. If you execute this one, yeah, come to exit. 5 is greater than, it will print the a is greater than b. Here a always greater than b. That is a simple expression here. That means in this way you will evaluate in the condition evaluation statement. This type of statement, if else statement, you call it as a conditional evaluation statement. Here for example, if you call the function here is a 2, 6. Here 2, 6 in the sense, the what is the value here? A is less than b. Here another condition, I am going to apply the another condition, 4, 4. Here a equal to b. Yeah, that means I applied the three different conditions here. This is, in this way you will evaluate the condition. This is a condition evaluation. Another one here is a for example, another statement. That means this type of function you will write in another way also. Here let us take a simple, I am taking the simple function here. Here what is the simple function in this case? Here there is a function is there. Let us take a simple test here. If condition, I am playing the if condition. If x less than y, the relation equal to less than, that means same function, same information writing in this way also. Relation, that means how can you do the relation here? You will use a relation statement. Here the same information represented by using a relation. A relation is declared inside the if block. The variable here, I am using the relation. Here if you call the relation, automatically execute the block of the statement here. Here that is a thing. If you execute this one, same function applied here. Here for example, the test of 5, 2, then the result here. Yeah, undefined. Yeah, test not defined. Execute here the function, define the test here. Test executed here. Text, yeah, it's not a text here. Test, yeah, x is greater than y. Here in this way you will perform the evaluation function here. Here not only in this different ways, here you will perform the if and else statement. Here by using if and else statement you will evaluate in the condition also. If condition, if x greater than, else positive, if x less negative. Here x greater than, here x greater than 0. Yeah, automatically it is a positive value here. This is a way. For example, before that you have to define the x value. Here what is the x value? Here without x value it is also taking the value. Previously x value I am taking the 5. Here okay, if you want to know, previously x value is there, value 5. if you want to execute this one, for example, I am taking the x equal to minus 1. Let us take minus 5. Here, if you execute this block here, it takes a negative. Yeah, it is a negative. In this way, you will write a different statements here. And then another important one here is a ternary operators. Here, what is a ternary here? Here, ternary. A, question mark, B, colon, C. Here, A is a condition. If A condition, if the condition true, the block of statements in a B executed. Else, the block of statement C executed. This is called here the conditional statement. Here, if these are all executed, the block of statement, if else statement, that's called here ternary operators. Here, let us take a simple ternary operator here. I'm going to write in the simple ternary operator. Here, let us take simple ternary operator. Yeah, x less than, simple ternary operator. If x less than, then less than, same thing. If else statement, same information applied by using x less than y. Here, then before that you have to give the x value. Here, for example, x equal to 5, y equal to 2. Y equal to 2. Let us execute this one. Here x less than, is it true or false? The syntax incompatible, syntax error. Yeah. Not less. Yeah. We are not giving the semicolon. Incompatible. Okay. Here, if you execute this one. Yeah, not less than. For example, a block of statement true or false, x less than y. This statement is false. Then the cursor directly comes to here. If we take this one, here, if it is a false, then the cursor comes to directly here, not here. That means this, in this way, you will performing the ternary operators here. It is not true. Then the cursor here. Here, another important operator here is a okay, leave it. Okay, I want to close this one. Okay, this is a, in this way you will perform in the ternary operator. That means set of statements true, then evaluate the operator, else evaluation. That means you will write a ternary operator within another ternary operator also. Here, that's a done by using here. That means you will write the ternary. For example, I am taking the text is a one condition here. That means the text, I am going to write the text value here. Let us take a simple example here. Here, text x comma y. Print x comma y here. That first here, execute this x is less than y. Else, the block of statements executed here. Again, ternary operator. Here, this is called here ternary operator within a ternary operator here. Here, the first statement here, let us take a simple. Yeah. If you take the simple statement here, for example, the entire block in this case, this is a. For example, a implies b. A in this case, it is a b. B block of statement executed. If you execute this one, the test here is a test executed. The test of 2,3. Here the 2,3 here is a 2,3. The first execute this condition 2,3 true. Then it will display the values x is less than y. Simply, yeah, x is less than y. Yeah, x is less than y. Then if it is a false statement, if you do the false statement here, the false statement in the sense the entire information is called here C. In the above statements, see the above statement. A is a condition. That means you are taking the simple condition. A is a condition. B is a if A condition true, then execute the B block statement. If A condition false, execute the C block statement. Here this is called here C block statement. Enter information X greater than. That means again you have a ternary operators. Here again that means how can you use a ternary operator? For example, I am giving the value here test of 3, 2. Test of 3, 2. What is the result here? The result here again it will test here. Here test 3, 2 condition false. Condition false. That's why the values tested here. It comes to here. Again test here 2, 3 greater than 2, yeah true, that's why 3 x is greater than y. Here in this way you will perform the ternary operators. Here another important one here is a shortcut evaluation operators. Here what is the shortcut evaluation? Here the shortcut evaluation operators are and or. Here that and or that means these are all called as a shortcut operators used to evaluating the true or false values. Here a and b and for example a and b, that is a, that means here in and indicates that if a true and b true, then only entire expression true. For example, A logical operator, A logical or operator, B, A or B, that means logical operator. This is called here logical operators A or B. This is a one way of shortcut evaluation. Let us take for doing this one here, I am taking a simple functions here. Here, for example, I am taking a simple function. First function here is a, take the first function. Here I am taking t of x is a int x comma 2. Here the x value here is a true value. Here I am taking this function as a first function. Here I am going to take the another function as a false function. Here for doing this one I am taking two functions. Here what are the two functions? Here the first function is a true function, second function is a false function. Then apply the these function values here. Here what are the function values? For example, I am taking the function here 1, 2, 1 and 2. Here t of information is true, t of information also a true, t of 1 true and then t of 2 true. True and true, that indicates the true value. The true and true, that indicates the true value. For example, one is true, another one is a false. Let us take a simple one. Here, the simple one here is a true statement here. It is a true statement. Again, it is a false statement. Here, T is a true statement. True and false. F is a false statement. True and false, that indicates the false statement. Let us take false and true. False and true also a false statement. Here false and true also a false statement here. And then similarly here in this way you will performing the shortcut evaluation operation. Here that is a information about the shortcut evaluation operator. Here another important one here is a while statement, very important while statement. Here what is a while statement here? Here the while syntax, the syntax for the while statement, what the, how can you represent the while statement? If the condition true, if there is a condition true, the block of statements executed. The syntax for the while loop like this. Here the syntax for the while loop here is a while boolean expression. What is a while loop here? The while loop used to iterate a set of statement over a collection of elements like an array. Here call here is a while loop here. Here if the condition here, the boolean expression true, if the boolean expression true, then the block of statement executed repeatedly here n number of time until the condition false. Yeah, the block of statement, the statement here, different. That means you will write the single statement or the block of statement here. That is called here while statement. Let us take a simple example here. While, for example, take a simple example. While condition. Here, take a simple information. While I'm writing the while statement, for example, take a while information. While n equal to zero, let us take a simple while statement. N equal to zero, n less than. Let us take. It is taking some time. Not executed. Yeah. Let us take a simple while statement here. Here, what is a simple while statement here? In this statement here, a equal to zero. I am taking the value here, a equal to zero. A less than 20. That means the block of statements executed repeatedly. A equal to a plus 4. Otherwise, you may take the a equal to a plus 4. Yeah, that means incrementing the a value by 4. First initially zero. That means that value takes a equal to a plus 4. Then a equal to 4. Here therefore again the again comes here the statement here. For example, take this one here. The first here these statements executed the block of statement. Then comes to here these statements. Here these statements. After that here the a print a value again comes to loop. A value, what is the a value here? Now a is a 4, a less than 20. Yeah, true. Then again execute this statement, a equal to a plus 4. Here second time execute this statement. Here a equal to a plus 4. Here a value 8, print 8. And then again comes here, 8 is less than 20. Here third time the block of statement executed 20. And then fourth time the 8 plus 12, 12 plus 16, and then after that the a value 20. If it is a 20, then 20 less than true, condition false, then the loop come out here. The come out here end the, that means it will execute the end statement. In this way you will performing the loop operations. Here this is a way of representing the loop operation. That means what is the result here? It will execute the 4, 8, 12, 16, 12. That means if you take the value here, I'm taking the 2. What is the result here? The first, how many times loop repeated here? 10 times. 2, 4, 6. Like this, you will execute the different statement. For example, Julia, another example here. That means if you take the Julia in a, let us take a simple example. Yeah, you will perform the while statement by using a string operators. Here I'm taking x equal to Uma, Rama, Siva is a three string operators here. Here, for example, I equal to 1, I less than length of the length function, it indicates the length value. For example, instead of length here, you may take the here. Let us execute this one here. Yeah, good to see you. X less than I equal to I plus 1. Here, instead of I, if it is a length value, length of like x of I. Here, if you take the dollar symbol address here, I'm going to pass in the address here. Then, what is the result here? That means Rayuma, Rama, Siva, good to see you. It will print the these values here. Here, in this way, you will apply the this kind of loop statement here. For example, the collection, that means for the collection also you may apply the loop statement here. For example, what are the collections here? For the collection while statement or do statement also you will apply the. The next important one here is a per statement. What is a per statement here? The per here, what is the syntax for the per statement here? The set of block of statements executed repeatedly for the first statement. Here for Julia, for loop used to iterate a set of statement over a range elements here are items of any array. Here that is called here Julia for statement here. The syntax for the for statement like this here, for x in range value. Here in this case here the syntax here represented as a for x in range condition or range collection, one colon five, that is a call here you are calling as a collections the statements and then end value. Here in this way you will performing the for statement. Let us take a simple example here. You may write the, for example, for n in one colon, let us take a simple representation. Yeah, here I am taking the for n in one, for example, I am taking a simple statement for n in the collection. I am going to take the collection here is a colon 5, n colon 5, and then I am going to printing the value here, print of n and then end. If you write the for statement, while statement, you require the end. End. Yeah. If you execute this one here, the collection of statement here executed one after another. Here in this way, you will execute the for statement here. If you want to execute the statement for I is equal to 1, the print, that means, yeah. If you take this one here, global I equal to I plus 1. Here, what are the result here? I less than 5. Here similar case applicable for the for loop here. The while loop and then for loop are similar statement. That means in both cases also you will use a, sometimes you will use a for statement, sometimes you will use a while statement here. For example, I am going to take the for statement for the array. That means previously I am taking for statement for the collection here. For example, for I in 1 colon 5, for I in 1 4 0. That means if you print this value here, it will print the automatically only 140 for in this way you will execute the for statement here. First execute the for in 1, for in 4, for in 0. Here this kind of information applicable for the for loop is applicable for the set of integer values, not only integer value here. Here this is applicable for the character and then string values also. For example, for x belongs to this value here. That means in this way you will execute the for statement. That means not only this information, you will execute this for statement for the set of block of statement. This for statement applicable for the that means within a for statement you will use a different kinds of if statement, that means break statement within a for statement here. You will execute, that means what is the break statement here? For j equal to 1 to 1000, let us take simple information. For j equal to 1 to 1000, print j. Here, if j greater than or equal to 5, if j value greater than or equal to 5, that means if you reach the 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that means automatically it will break the value. Here the statement executes the breaking, break the value, and then here what is the result here? Not executing the here. If you do this one here is a 1 to 5 only. Here if you remove the break statement here, here if you remove the break statement, it automatically print the 1000 numbers. 1000. That means it will print the up to 1000. Here without break statement. Here in this way you will use a for statement. Not only break statement here. In a for statement you will use a continue statement also. The continue statement also one of the thing here. For example, for I equal to 1 to 10. That means the collection I am taking, if I percentage I mod 3 is not equal to 0. I mod 3, I value 1. 1 mod 3 is not equal to 0. And then 2 mod 3 not equal to 0. 3 mod 3 is not equal to 0. Yes, it is true. That means that it will not display the 3 value. Here continue, end. And then print. Here, if you execute this one, yeah, here the first statement here is a 1. Here continue. Here not true. Here if you comes to 3 mod 3, the remainder value here is a, I'm taking the remainder value 0. That means continue. That means end print 3. Again, 6. If it is a 6, not equal to 0, continue. Again, 6, 9. In particular cases here, that means not only the statement here, you will execute the collection also. Here, that means for the, you may use the nested for loop also. Here, how can you write the nested for loop? For loop within a or multiple or nested for loops, you may write the multiple or nested for loop for this statement. Here, for example, I'm going to writing the nested for loop like this. For example, I equal to 1 to 2, j equal to 3 to 4, and then print j. That means how can you execute here? First I value equal to 1, for j value equal to 3. For that one, print the 1 comma 3. Next, I value 1. For the I value 1, J value 4. 1 comma 4. Is it clear, Anna? Here, first, for the I value 1, J equal to 3 comma 4. For next, I value 2, J equal to 3 comma 4. If you execute this one here, the print, the matrix, it will print the matrix here. 1 comma 3, 1 comma 4, 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4. Here, this is called here nested for loop. For loop within the next important one, exceptions. What is an exception here? Here, exceptions are thrown when an unexpected condition has occurred. Here, you have a different types of built-in exceptions are there. Here, augment error exception, divided by zero exception. For example, any number by zero. That is called here built-in exception. Here EOF error exception, and then error exception. That means so many built-in exceptions are there. Here, for example, square root minus 1. That is called here error here. Here, for example, if you want to execute a square root value in Julia, here square root minus 1, this is a function. It's called here exception, a domain error. This type of errors occur in a throw here. Here, this type of errors are going to be handled here by using thrown. Here, the exception can be created explicitly with the thrown here. Here, this particular thrown here, for example, you may execute the thrown. For example, let us take a simple exception. I'm going to write the simple exception like this. Here f of x equal to x greater than 0 is exponential exp of minus x. Here otherwise you may same square root. So you may take the square sq or the square root of minus 1. Here in particular cases here it throws the exception value. Here if you execute this one here, for example, yeah, it is a function created. For example, I am going to take the same minus 1, here 1 or 2 or 3. Here 1 indicates the minus 1. Automatically value is a minus 1. Here then only it throws a certain, here previously error is there, domain error. What is the domain error? Not a domain error here. It's a thrown some exception. Okay, instead of square root, same, it is taking some domain error. Yeah. Okay, take this exception value here. Exponential value. Exponential of here for this exponential. How can you get this one? Minus one is here is a error. Yeah. Instead of previously you may write the square root here. Square root of minus 2. Here minus 3 also you may write. Here exception value, here it is taking the thrown. Here not only this type of handling the this type of exceptions, you may use a some blocks here, try or catch block here. for this handling the this type of exception here. Here, try or catch statement allows the exception to be tested for a graceful handling. That means for handling the exceptions, you will take the try and catch block here. Here, what is the try block? What is, how can you write the try block? How can you write the catch block in Julia here? That means you are writing the try block, catch block in this way. Let us take, try. Here, the I'm writing the square root 10. That means if it is a any error, that error handled by the catch block. Here you should have entered the numeric value. Here, for example, execute this one here. If you execute this one, try, incomplete. The completion not done here. For this one, I am going to writing a function here. The function name here is a square root function. Here the square root function consists of, for this one, I'm going to writing the function here. So what is the function here? The square root function here. Within the square root function, I am writing the try block here. Square root of x of 2. Here, if you execute this one here, here I'm going to writing the square root value here. Here, the square root. Square root of 4. It is taking some time. The 4 value here, I am taking the square root value here, 2. Here, for example, minus 4. How can you get the square root value? Here, minus can, it is a error here. It is a, use a complex value, 0.4 IM. Here, for example, I am going to write the square root for the 9. The square root value for the 9 also, for example, square root here. For the square root 16, what is the value here? It is 4. Here, in this way, you will execute the try and catch block here.